Hey, good optometry morning. Dr. Michael Nelson here, and welcome to Sunday Studies, where I review a eye research study. Okay, so if you're using or thinking of using atropine for the treatment of myopia progression, you need to be aware of the ATOM studies. So I did a review of ATOM number one study, and you can find a link to it up here. But today I'm going to be talking about ATOM 2. So if you prefer to read the study, I've put the links to these studies down below in the description, and you could take a look and read them and analyze them and review them yourself. But today I'm going to make it easier on you because I'm going to do that for you, and I'm going to review the ATOM 2 study, and I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about this study and what they don't tell you in just the abstract. And I'm going to do all of that in under 7 minutes. All right, and during this video, I'm going to give you 5 pearls that you can take away from the ATOM 2 study to make you an expert. But time is ticking, so let's go. Okay, so this study is called Atropine for the Treatment of Childhood Myopia, Safety and Efficacy of 0.5%, 0.1%, and 0.01% doses. It's referred to as the ATOM 2 study. So now this study had 3 phases in it, and the data was released in actually 3 different studies. Okay, as a quick review, ATOM number 1 study showed that 1% atropine is effective in reducing myopia progression. However, there are 2 problems, let's call them side effects of 1% atropine. And what they are is, number 1, they dilate your pupils, so things are really bright, so you might have to wear sunglasses. And number 2, they freeze your accommodation or your focusing ability, so you might need to use bifocal lenses. So the theory is this: if we give you a lower dose of atropine, you're likely to get less of these symptoms. And so that's what ATOM 2 study is looking at. They're looking at using lower dosages of atropine and see if they still reduce the myopia progression, but give you less symptoms. So like ATOM 1, this is a double-masked randomized study that took about 400 kids ages 6 to 12 year olds and looked at their myopia progression. So this study had 3 phases in it. Phase 1 was looking at years 1 and 2, phase 2 was looking at year 3, and phase 3 was looking at years 4 and 5. So in phase 1, they looked at these 3 dosages of atropine, which were lower than those used in Atropine 1 study, to see if they were as effective in lowering myopia progression and if they caused less symptoms. So what they did was they used 1 drop in each eye every evening for 2 years. So this is a little bit different than ATOM 1, because in ATOM 1, they put the drop only in one eye and they used the other eye as a form of a placebo. Okay, so let's first of all talk about whether these lower dosages caused less symptoms. So what they found out was the 0.01% caused very little pupil dilation and very little loss of your focusing ability. The other dosages did cause pupil dilation and did affect your focusing ability. So pearl number 1, 0.01% has very little effect on pupils and your accommodation. So did these lower dosages actually reduce the progression of myopia? So here's a table and a summary of the changes in the amount of myopia. So it includes the info from the ATOM 1 study, which I've highlighted here in yellow. So what you'll see in this graph is the lowest line is the placebo group, and they had the biggest increase in myopia progression over 2 years. And the upper line is the 1% atropine that was used in the ATOM 1 study, and that has the least amount of progression of myopia over 2 years. Now what you'll see is that the lower dosages of atropine that were used in the ATOM 2 study also showed a significant reduction in the progression of myopia, not quite as much as 1% atropine, but still very, very significant. So pearl number 2 from the ATOM study shows that lower dosages of atropine are almost as effective as 1% atropine in slowing the amount of myopia progression. So they also looked at axial length, and what you'll see is that the 0.1% and the 0.5% concentration showed less growth of the eye than the 0.01%. And so what's interesting is if you compare the ATOM 1 and the ATOM 2 data, it looks like the 0.01% had almost as much growth as the placebo eye did. So one important thing to be aware of is that the ATOM 1 and the ATOM 2 studies did not use the same method to measure the axial length. So we can't really compare the axial length measurements in ATOM 1 and ATOM 2 directly. They did use the same method of measuring the myopia progression, so we can compare ATOM 1 to ATOM 2 for those. Okay, so leading up to pearl number 3, there's an interesting thing that you won't get from reading the abstract. So if you're an astute reader of this study, you will notice that there is no control group in the ATOM 2 study. And in actual fact, the researchers had intended that the control group was going to be the 0.01% atropine group, because they thought that's such a low dose of atropine that it's not going to have any effect on myopia progression and it's not going to have any effect on symptoms. And so pearl number 3 is 0.01% is an effective control of myopia. And that was kind of a surprise. So I mentioned that ATOM 2 study has three phases. So what I just described was phase number one. So in phase number two, what they did is they stopped all the drops for everyone and they just followed people for 1 year because they wanted to see if there was any myopic rebound effect. So here's a summary graph of that study, and this is what they found. There was a myopic rebound after atropine was stopped, and it was greater in the eyes that received the higher concentrations of 0.5% and 0.1% atropine. But the myopic rebound effect for the 0.01% was much more modulated and sustained than the higher concentrations. So pearl number four is 0.01% atropine has less myopic rebound than the higher concentrations do. So in phase three, what they looked at is some of those that had continued to progress in phase two, and they decided, let's put them back on atropine. So they put them back on atropine and that they put them on the lowest dosage, the 0.01% atropine. And then they followed them for years four and five. And what they found is that that reduction in the myopia progression continued. So here's pearl number five from ATOM 2 study. The higher dosages of atropine seem to have an initial higher reduction in myopia progression, but over the long period, over the long haul, over 5 years, 0.01%, the lowest dosage of atropine, seemed to have the best effect in lowering myopia progression with the least amount of symptoms. All right, so that's your crash course on ATOM number two study. Make sure you hit the bell and the subscribe button so you get more notifications of videos just like this, and have a great optometry day.